Morning children, today we are going to begin with the fifth chapter of history. What books and burials tell us? What books and burials tell us? What is the meaning? Books, from the books, what were the ancient books or all the books, what we are learning, what we are getting the information. What burials? Burials are the places where the dead bodies are buried in the ancient men. We know that the ancient period, people used different methods of burying the dead bodies. So from the learn, from observing or excavating the places of burial grounds, what information do we get about the past? So here there is a small story given about a girl, okay, Mary, in the library. So let's see here, as the bell rang, the teacher asked the students to follow him. When the bell rang, teacher along with the students went to a library. For the children, for the first time, they were entering in a library. Okay, you have a library in our school and you are going and learning, reading books there. Okay, along with the, all these children entered, Mary also was a small girl. She went, stepped inside the library. She found that the library is much larger than the classroom. Library is very bigger. So in the classroom, there were many shelves, many books were there, all of large number of books were there, full of books. In a corner of a cupboard also, filled with a large old volumes of books. It was not modern books, different categories were, some regions were arranged, books about stories, books about sports, books about education, etc., etc. In one cupboard, old, very old books were there. And she was surprised seeing that. The teacher said that cupboard is very particular, special books are about there, about religion. So this cupboard is meant for religious books. All religious books are there, about all types of religions, whether Hinduism or Islam or Buddhism, Sikhism, etc., are preserved in this cupboard. So here Mary wondered what is a religion. As Mary is a small child, she could not understand what is religion. She had never heard about the Vedas and all. So here we are going to, in this chapter, we are going to learn some about the old books or oldest books in the world. They are the Vedas. So how many of you have heard about Vedas? Have you heard about Vedas? What is Vedas? There are four. These are the very ancient Hindu textbooks, Hindu religious textbooks. Okay. Now we can consider it is Hindu religious textbooks. Okay. There are four Vedas. Four of them are there. Vedas are four. Vedas are ancient textbooks which was written in India. Okay. So the Rig Veda, Samaveda, Yajur Veda, and Atharva Veda. These are the four Vedas. You have studied in the previous classes about Vedas. Rig Veda, Samaveda, Yajur Veda, and Atharva Veda. These are the four Vedas. Among these, the four Vedas, the oldest Veda is the Rig Veda. Oldest Veda is the Rig Veda. Rig Veda is the oldest Veda. It was written about, it was not written, but it was composed about 3500 years ago. Composed, not written completely, okay. And Rig Veda includes more than 1000 hymns are there. Hymns means the songs or pray in order to praise the gods. Okay, hymns are called in Rig Veda. These hymns or the poems, we can say poems or shlokas, they are called Sukta in Rig Veda. In Rig Veda, all these hymns are written in the Sukta, as it is called Sukta, which means well said, okay, properly said. So these hymns are in praise of many gods and goddesses. In Hinduism, we know that there are many thousands of gods and goddesses are there. So in praise of these gods and goddesses, these hymns are written. So there are many various gods in Hinduism. There are three gods are especially very important gods in Hinduism or in Rig Veda. three gods are mentioned. More importantly, they are Agni. Agni, you know that this is the god of fire. Indra is the god of war, or he is a warrior god and god of battle. Another one is Soma, which is a plant. Soma is a plant which is a kind of drink is obtained from Soma. So these are Agni, Indra and Soma are three important gods mentioned in the Rig Veda. Okay, so these hymns were composed by sages or rishis. Sages means holy men. Rishis, okay, we say rishis. So these hymns or poems or suktas were composed by the rishis also. Okay. So how these were taught? We know that those periods there were no writing methods. Okay. So that people used to dictate to their students. So who were the gurus or teachers? Were the priests? Priests taught the children or students to recite and memorize each syllable or word or sentence. Everything, as all the suktas, as a word or syllable or the sentences were taught to the children, to the students by a priest or a guru, orally only. Okay, so it was recited, people or students had to memorize, repeating several times, they had to memorize all this bit by bit. Okay, so very carefully, with great care, without any mistake, because there was no writing system, so that they had to learn by heart and memorize it. So most of these hymns were composed or taught by the learned men, very highly skilled or educated men prepared all these hymns. Also few of them were composed by the women also. Rig Veda is one of the oldest or old Vedic Sanskrit is. Okay. It is also written in the Sanskrit language. Okay. The Rig Veda is written in the old Sanskrit language. We know that there are differences in the modern Sanskrit which we are learning in the schools, as a subject is different from the Vedic Sanskrit. The terms of the which were used in the ancient Sanskrit or Vedic Sanskrit is different than the modern Sanskrit language which we are learning in the schools. Okay. So here, what is Sanskrit and other languages? Sanskrit is a part of the family of languages known as Indo-European. So there are different families, different classes of the languages. So one is Indo-European language. So Sanskrit is part of Indo-European language. Why? We know that some say Indian languages like Assamese, Gujarati, Hindi, Kashmiri, Sindhi, etc. These are all part of Sanskrit languages, because Asian languages like Persian and many European languages such as English, French, German, Greek, Italian and Spanish belong to this family, Indo-European language family. Because why these are called the same family? All because many of the are originally we can find many of the words in common. In all these languages, some words are commonly found, so that these all are coming under one family. So we can say some example, in Sanskrit we use the word matr for mother. In Hindi we say ma, or in English mother. So there are some similarities, matr in Sanskrit or ma in Hindi or mother in English. These all have some similarities, so that these are all languages come under one family or one group of languages, that is called Indo-European languages. Now we can say other languages used in the subcontinent. In India itself we can find India and Indian subcontinent, different families of languages we can find in our country also. For instance, those used in the North India or Northeast regions of our country, Tibeto-Burman family. Tibeto-Burman family, because it is bordering, northeastern regions are bordering with Tibet and Burma, so that is called the Tibeto-Burman family. But you can find out the South Indian languages, Tamil, Telugu, Kannada and Malayalam. these all belonging to Dravidian family, because we know that these all four languages have some similar words or common words in this. Okay, so these are called, or we can find again changes in some of the regions like Jharkhand in our country, the central India. Jharkhand and parts of central India belong to the Austroasiatic family, that is also a different language. So all these changes are there. Some languages have some similarities, many of the languages have some similarities, they belong to one particular language family. So here we can find the books which we are using nowadays, they are printed books are available now. But in case of Rigveda, when we go back to history, Rigveda was recited continuously. It was dictated by the teachers to students. Okay, then the students heard it, and continuously they were passing from one generation to other generation. After many centuries, it was written. Okay, when it was first composed 3500 years ago, but it was written many years later, several centuries later only. Okay, so printed, we hear the printing also introduced in the modern world about 200 years ago only. It was first printed, printing started just 200 years ago, then these books were printed. So tomorrow we'll study about how historians study about Rigveda.